Sullivan. I'm a former IRS agent and teaching instructor with the Internal Revenue Service. I worked at IRS for 10 years. I've been in private practice for 40 years. I am one of the most, foremost experts on IRS matters. I've been doing this a long time, and I have a whole team of former IRS agents that work with me. I've been on TV quite a bit, and you can see my news clips and my team at 777irs.com. You can find me in the description section below. Anyway, I do these videos for three reasons. A, so you don't get ripped off. There's a lot of garbage on the internet, and people, you need to pay attention. You don't need to be in a suit. You can be right here in your own living room in the underwear, which I'm in, just blogging, giving it to you all day long. But if they're reading scripts and they're too fancy, they're not for you. Just so you know, I like to give you insider information from IRS, so you kind of know what a former agent thinks. You're getting 50 years of experience with me, and I like to educate you really a lot. Today I'm going to talk about IRS audits and how and why your return got pulled for an audit, so you know the actual process of how the audit got to be the audit. So what IRS does, there's a lot of reasons you can get audited. There are a list of reasons. You can go on the internet and find out 8 million reasons why your tax return got audited. The bottom line is the computer pulled your case for audit. An IRS agent at the time that it was pulled did not pull your return for audit. There was something wrong with your DIF score, your discriminatory index function score. By the way, you'll never find that out, but IRS has targeted your tax return for an audit. With that, they send batches of these returns that the computer pulled down to the local office, and people there who grade these, whether these have audit potential or not, then they put a cover letter and send them back up. Then they're sent down to the different offices to go ahead and they pull them for audit. Now keep in mind, IRS really has a budget they have to work with, and they can only do so many audits. Just the way it is. It's just like a regular business. Every office may do 200 audits a year. I don't know what that number is, but that's how that works. So what happens at that point in time, the revenue agent or the person looking at your audit will send out what's called a doc request. It says, hey, guess what? I'm doing your audit. It's a nasty gram. And they will send you a bunch of information they want from you. When you look at that letter, you will find out that's why your return got kicked out for an audit. It's that simple. So the computer pulled your return. Someone looked at your tax return and seen it was audit worthy. And then somebody at the local office sent a letter out to audit you. That doesn't mean that IRS is right. There's no need to get scared or worried. At the end of the day, when this process is complete, you're either going to owe money or not. Now, if you owe money, relax. IRS has payment programs, hardship programs, offer and compromise programs. They have three different programs once the billing process starts. If you do not like the way the audit, in fact, turned out, you simply go ahead and ask the agent that you want an appeal. They send you a letter, and you have 30 days in which you can go ahead and you can appeal the finding. Then you go to the appellate division. Appellate division is a little more friendly. They kind of oversee what the other person did. You're allowed to bring a more record. You're allowed to maybe reconstruct some things. Maybe your auditor was a little bit of a hard ass or something like that. So they are a more seasoned person who will give you a kind of a real fair trial. And if you don't like that, you can actually go to tax court from that. So remember, at the end of the day, this isn't a death sentence to you. You now know the audit process. But even if you're set up for an audit deficiency, You still had, remember, your appellate rights. You could have gone to tax court. At the end of this period, just so you know, the case now goes to the collection division to be worked. You're first going to get a letter, and then a period of, let's see, about 3 months later, you will get four IRS notices. You will get a CP 501, 503, 504, and then the 1058. And at that point in time, you want to have an exit strategy on how you're going to deal with the Internal Revenue Service. That's simply it. If you need audit representation, we have some of the best auditors, former IRS auditors on staff. If you owe money, we can do your representation as well. If this video was helpful, I would appreciate a subscription. Subscriptions are really, really, really big because YouTube grades us on subscriptions. Anyway, thank you. You're welcome to leave a comment. You're welcome to leave me a like, but I do appreciate your subscription. Thank you very much.